Hi Joe, I thought I'd get a quick video in here to make a clarification from my last video. I appreciate your compliments for my last video, and I have watched that video once. I will watch it again and try to get more out of it. I just need a little more time. Today we did go to the Fed. We also visited the U.S. Mint. We went to the Second Bank of the United States, and we also visited the old Bourse building in Philadelphia, the old stock exchange, and had a great time. It's always nice to have some type of active learning lesson rather than just sit up there and lecture. And this was kind of the appropriate day where we kind of, culminated our study of the Fed by going there and getting involved with their money in motion exhibit. I also want to thank you for your offer to come visit my students. We're about an hour from the Philadelphia area, but we'll take you up on that. That would be a great thing for you to come to our school. I don't know, scheduling wise, how that would work out. We have a semesterized system, so our kids take their classes for 4.5 months, and they spend an hour and 20 minutes or so per class, and then they're done, and then they go into the new semester. So I'm going to lose my students after the first week of February. As far as the video, you're right. I didn't really use the appropriate language or words that I should have. I should have been much more explicit because, if anything, I'm the last person that would not think in the we mentality. And in fact, my name on the YouTube channel, I generalis undered, has non nobis solum, which is actually the school's motto. It's been around probably before the Titanic, meaning not just to ourselves. So I definitely don't have the type of mindset where I'd want to think how any one monetary system would benefit me. And I was unclear. But what I do want to say about that, though, is that I think many Americans do have that type of psychology that they do make decisions based on what benefit their pocketbooks, and that's very troublesome because it can hurt others. There used to be a phrase in Russian, I'm going to translate it into English, that what's good for a Russian can kill a German, so to speak. And a lot of problems can arise from people simply voting their pocketbooks. The other thing that I wanted to mention was, I guess you spoke about the public versus private. I was unclear on that too, to be frank with you, because I think where that comes from is when I think of the Federal Reserve, I keep thinking of a private corporation. I mean, I know there are public aspects of the Federal Reserve, such as, say, the President and Congress deciding, the Board of Governors and whatnot, and then the actual Federal Reserve Act could be changed or repealed at any time. But in general, I think of it, again, as that private corporation. So I use that word quite frequently. I probably should use the money market system versus the public money system, and I think I would have been a little bit better off. That's not exactly how Dr. Yamaguchi would term it, but it probably would have been better if I used that. But I have to be very careful about my language because I remember back to college, one of my professors said, I'm just going to paraphrase it because I can't remember his exact words, but it was just the caveat that in economics, if you say one term in a way that you didn't want to say, or inappropriately, or in some way that would make somebody misunderstand you can have the entirely opposite opinion or effect of what you were trying to say. And I guess that was the case. But again, I think it came out of the idea that the Fed was a private corporation, so I immediately just used that expression. Private money versus public money. So, yeah. So it's good. I mean, and I have very thick skin, so I'm glad you pointed that out. So I hope to have my discussion with you continue. I'm going to have to get your opinion about this idea about Americans or in general. I mean, I don't want to typecast everybody, but in general, I think that there is that problem where people will vote their pocketbooks. That's going to be a problem, I think, if the monetary system changes, because you're going to have your representatives think that way. And I not for a minute believe that my representatives, at least they would have that type of attitude. But that's another story for another video, but I think that would be a nice area to touch upon. So again, thank you very, very much for your video. I wanted to get this one out quickly because I have to grade papers tonight and plan for tomorrow. But I appreciate your video and your compliments. So we'll see you soon, Joe. Enjoy your week. See you.